Hey guys, today we're going to be reacting to the Evolution of Godzilla. His channel will be linked in the description and the video will be. So let's go.
Since being awoken by atomic bombs, Godzilla has lit up the silver screen.
He had a sleeping mask.
But his looks seem to be ever-changing, starting with the original. Let's go through his theatrical looks and story. Animated. In his first ever appearance, Godzilla has small arms, big legs, and dorsal plates down his spine. His pupils are tiny, and he has fangs and pointy ears. After attacking Japan, he gets disintegrated to bone. A new Gigantus, Godzilla, appears in Godzilla Raids Again. This monster is thinner, with longer arms, a smaller head, and larger pupils. When in close-ups, his teeth appear to be jutting out. Sadly, he's buried in ice. But in King Kong vs. Godzilla, he busts free. He's now in color. He's more plump,
toeless,
and has a lizard-like head with yellow eyes, no ears, and no fangs. He faces off against a giant ape, tumbling into the ocean, only to be washed ashore in Mothra vs. Godzilla. Now he's slimmer, has a whiter head, white eyes, and smooth, shiny brows.
I like him better with yellow eyes.
As his rampage continues, he gets covered in silk and again drops into the sea.
Is that the Mothra lava?
But in Ghidorah, the three-headed monster, he's back.
Ghidorah?
Now with a slimmer face and longer tongue. From this film on in the original series, Godzilla now defends humanity from more evil monsters.
Get away from the dragon.
In Invasion of Astro Monster, Godzilla is thinner. Yeah. His dorsal plates have more definition. His claws are dull, and his head is rounder. He shows off his new dance moves before briefly being put under alien mind control. Ibera, Horror of the Deep,
gives
Godzilla less angry brows. He battles against a big lobster and narrowly escapes an exploding island. In the sequel, Godzilla's neck is elongated. He's pudgier, and his dorsal fins are flimsy-looking. His nose is also stubbier, and his eyes are bugged out. Oh, and he's now raising a hideous son. In Destroy All Monsters, he's slimmer, while his face appears more like it did in Astro Monster. He's put under alien mind control again, but once free of their control, he turns on them. For the next three sequels, his look remains consistent. In the first, he helps his son face off against a bully. However, this all takes place inside the dreams of a young boy, so... Moving on. Godzilla vs. Ghidorah, he opposes a pollution monster, and when curled up like a shrimp, he can now fly backwards. In Godzilla vs. Gigan, Godzilla has gained the ability to speak, while his skin, starts ripping during his triumphant battle. He appears slimmer in Godzilla vs. Megalon, with a shorter neck, soft bright
fins,
and a round pig-nosed face. He boasts a
robot.
This movie is mostly about a size-changing robot, so let's keep going. In the next two films, Godzilla has an angrier expression and more detailed muzzle. He uses a magnetic upgrade to protect an ancient god from Mechagodzilla. And in the sequel, faces him once more. But this time when Godzilla is sent to retirement,
Manila and
this
Asian god, Rodan,
Godzilla appears. This one's taller, has larger dorsal fins, a fourth toe, and his fangs in the ears make a return, although his reign is short-lived as he trips into a volcano, only to explode out in the sequel. He has a smaller head.
I don't know if it's pronounced Biollante or Biollante. I thought you say Biollante.
A secondary row of teeth. He takes on a giant plant monster.
It's his sister.
Turned into glitter. In Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, his original form, the Godzillasaurus, is taken out of the 1940s.
I'm getting flashbacks from 1998.
Turning him into a taller, muscular, and angrier-looking Godzilla.
Ew.
He fights Mecha King Ghidorah and then gets dumped into the ocean. In Godzilla vs. Mothra, he's thinner. His dorsal plates are rearranged, and his neck is more ribbed. His head is flatter, and he has golden eyes. He battles against
Mothra and Batra,
and once again is plunged into the ocean and locked in by Mothra's magical powers. But somehow, in Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla 2, he's back. He has slimmed down shoulders and slimmer legs. He's also raising a blue-toned baby Godzilla. This time he's defeated when his butt brain is destroyed, but it's easily revitalized just moments later.
Rodan.
Godzilla vs. Space Godzilla features the
big, weird, crystally Godzilla.
Less detailing in the neck and larger eyes. Godzilla Jr., who is taller and chubbier with a greener color scheme, and a large flying blue crystallized Space Godzilla, who gets obliterated. In this timeline's final film, Godzilla is glowing orange, and his son
well,
looks
nuclear,
more like a hunched version of his father. When the
Burning
original
Godzilla.
Big G has a meltdown, his son absorbs the radiation and turns into the new Godzilla, ready for action.
Looks like a gangster.
But the series would be continually rebooted, dropping him altogether. The first American Godzilla appears as a large mutated iguana with blue dorsal spines and a hanging dewlap. This Godzilla also has hundreds of tiny raptor-looking offspring. But this happy family is easily taken out by basic explosives.
Oh,
back
sad.
In Japan, in Godzilla 2000, he appears shorter, with green jagged skin, sharp purple spines,
and a lizard-like
head. Reptilian-looking face.
A
while he's nearly swallowed whole, he's good to go for the next reboot, Godzilla vs. Megaguirus, in which he's lighter, with a longer neck, and smaller mouth. He defeats a giant flying insect and is then sent into a black hole. In giant monsters all-out attack, Godzilla is formed by the ghost of vengeful World War II victims.
He's got a hunched neck and white eyes.
He has smooth charcoal-colored skin, white dorsal fins, and a hunched neck. His face is less lizard-like, with pure white eyes and no ears. But this Godzilla is mutilated by a drill missile, leaving only his beating heart behind.
Yeah, I know.
The following reboot, Godzilla Against Mechagodzilla, re-adds the jagged design elements and introduces a more wolf-like face. In the climax, he's blasted by
he's
a beam,
turn into
a visible scar to his chest
from
the
final
sequel,
wars.
Tokyo SOS, in which he's covered in silk and again flown into the bottom of the sea.
Godzilla Final Wars.
Godzilla Final Wars features a taller, smoother, and more slender Godzilla, with longer ears and red eyes. This Godzilla fights against a multitude of creatures. Including an upright standing 98 Zilla.
Monsters.
Then he and his hideous son head back to the ocean. In Shin Godzilla, he's first shown as a light colored and armless creature, but quickly evolves, growing tiny arms and becoming more red with bloody accents. His massive main form is darker with a much longer tail and a little face on the end. His jaw can unhinge and split apart, and he has a variety of handy new skills.
That's cool. I'm gonna watch this.
Produce human hybrids from his tail tip. Body's given a freezing agent, ceasing his evolution.
Oh.
The anime trilogy depicts a muscular, rounded
Godzilla Earth
or
Godzilla Plant.
19,000 years later,
Plant,
he sports beard-like
monsters.
Spikes and grows to his largest on-screen size, easily allowing him to become the ruler of Earth. Meanwhile, back in 2014, a plump American Godzilla appears. This titan has jagged dorsal plates, wide elephant-like feet, and noticeable gills. He comes out of hiding to stop two hideous star-crossed lovers. In Godzilla, King of the Monsters, he's taller and beefier. His lower half looks less stubby, his tail tip is more blunt, and his dorsal fins are less sharp and artfully glowing.
Oh yeah,
later,
I watched that yesterday.
He's given extra radiation, and after ashes rain down on him, he gets a fiery new look and power upgrade, helping him to retain his kingly crown. Thank you for watching.
You
liking
guys,
and
also thank you for watching.
And as always,
Kong will be
thank
next.
You to the patrons for supporting
subscribe
the channel.
And,
Did you like to see more kaiju?